Today's lab is on classifying solutions as strong, weak, or non-electrolytes based on light bulb brightness. An electrolyte is an aqueous solution that will conduct electricity. Electricity is the flow of electrons. A non-electrolyte is an aqueous solution that does not conduct electricity because there are no ions present. An example would be a covalent compound. Electrolytes can be classified further as a strong or a weak electrolyte. A strong electrolyte means we have 75 to 100% ions. A weak electrolyte has very few ions present in its solution. Some examples of strong electrolytes are soluble ionic compounds. For example, table salt, sodium chloride. This is a compound, when we put it in water, it dissolves, so it's soluble, and it forms ions. So for example, NaCl, when I put that into water, it 100% forms ions. We have sodium ions and chloride ions in our aqueous solution. The same thing with strong acids and strong bases. They form 100% ions as well. Versus a weak electrolyte would be examples of weak acids or weak bases. These are when we dissolve them in water, most of the compound stays together as a molecule, and a few ions are formed, just a small amount. So how today's experiment is going to work is you're going to take a number of solutions, you're going to test the solutions, see if they have ions present. If they have ions present, our light bulb will light up. So you have an apparatus that's set like this. We have a positive and a negative probe, the cathode and the anode. And you're going to take your solution, for example, if we had sodium chloride here, and you would put the probes into the solution and see if it would conduct electricity. So what happens if we have sodium ions? They're going to be attracted to the negative side, because opposites always attract. If we have chloride ions, they'll be attracted to the positive side. So this flow of these ions actually completes the circuit that causes our light bulb to light up. If we have a non-electrolyte, again, there's no ions present. If there's no ions present, then the light bulb will not light up. So let's go ahead and take a look at our solutions. The first compound we're going to test today is deionized water. We're going to bring the beaker containing the DI water up so the probes are inside our solution, swirl a little bit, and check our light bulb to see if we're conducting any electricity. And as the name implies, deionized means the ions were taken out of the water, so we would not expect that to light up the light bulb. Next one we have is tap water. If I swirl my tap water, we can see the filament is lighting up slightly. Now, between each solution, it's very important that you always clean the probes with deionized water to make sure there's not any remaining ions left on those probes. The next solution is sodium chloride, and here we can see we have a very bright light, which again, the bright light tells us we have plenty of ions in our solution. So again, we're going to clean our probes. The next solution is sodium hydroxide. Multiple containers of DI water to make sure our probes are clean. Next we have hydrochloric acid. One thing that's important when you're doing this experiment is to be careful not to ever touch those probes, because you can get a very nasty shock. This was H2SO4, sulfuric acid. Phosphoric acid, H3PO4. Copper sulfate. The solution in this one is this blue color. That's due to the copper ions that give it that lovely blue color. NH3, ammonia, aqueous solution. Acetic acid. Sucrose. We have an aqueous solution of sucrose, also known as sugar. And the last solution is ethanol, which is drinking alcohol. So again, you're recording in your notebook with these solutions if they conduct electricity or not, based on how much the light bulb lights up, whether they are non-electrolytes, weak or strong electrolytes. For part two of conductivity of solutions, you are going to mix an aqueous solution of ammonia with acetic acid, and then you're going to form ammonium ions and acetate ions. You're going to take, before you mix them together, you'll take your aqueous ammonia solution and add phenolphthalein to it. Phenolphthalein is a color indicator to tell you if your solution is an acid or a base. If your solution color turns pink, it means your solution is basic. If your solution is clear, it means your solution is either neutral or acid. We don't know which one. So one thing to know when we're doing this portion of the experiment is when we start with ammonia, aqueous ammonia solution, which is a weak base, means that there's very few ions present. Again, weak acids and weak bases are weak electrolytes, so we have very, very little ions. So we tested its conductivity and saw that we had a very dim light bulb. When we add acetic acid, also a weak acid, very few ions present. So notice they're written as a molecular form here. When we add them together, when we form ammonium ion and acetate ion, we are forming ions. So we'll be testing the conductivity of the solution after it's mixed with our light bulb apparatus. I am rechecking the conductivity of my aqueous ammonia solution. See that I have just the filaments lit up. It is a weak electrolyte. Cleaning the probes with the DI water. Retesting my acetic acid. Again, weak electrolyte. Cleaning my probes with DI water. And now to my ammonia solution, I'm going to go ahead and add a couple drops of phenolphthalein. And you can note the color that you're observing here. And now I'm going to go ahead and add my acid, my acetic acid. And I have equal volumes of each, and notice the color change. So now I have my addition of acetic acid to my ammonia, and I'm going to test its conductivity in my probe. And we see that we have a much brighter light bulb when the two solutions are combined to do our acid-based reaction. We created more ions.